Yeah, I just be corny. We have to adjust this for the next clip. I don't know. But anyway, the end of vlog today is Thursday at 11 o'clock. And I'm going to get my YouTube changed today. So that I vlog. So I may not. Thank you for the light. I may not film the actual, like, procedure. But it's same every time, so it's nothing new. And I honestly thought my battery would be full because I haven't used this camera, but it's not, but I guess it's okay. And so yeah, but like I said, my battery, I thought it'd be full because I haven't used it, but I think I used it once, like a couple months ago, but I haven't charged it since, so it's my fault. But anyway, so I'm gonna be tubing today. Then I vlog, like I said, probably won't film the actual procedure, but so yeah. Bye for now, guys.
Ollie, you wanna say good morning?
He's not like my other cat was. My other cat was all about the camera. Some of the, but yeah, the best away in 2017. He was all about the camera. Ollie's kind of camera shy. So anyway, bye for now, guys. Hello, everybody. I'm sitting here waiting on the cab. I'll probably go in a minute, but the tube change went really well, and it was really quick, and we were scheduled for pickup at, like, 2:10, my appointment, or 3:10. Scheduled for pickup at 3:10, my appointment's at 1:10, and now it's 1:42, and she said, we're set to schedule for pickup at 3:10, so we're gonna have to wait here, but we probably won't wait outside all the whole time, but anyway, I'm just sitting here, and my mom found an old bag of candy. Probably it's not expired, it's from February.
I don't know.
You're gonna eat the candy, aren't you?
Not right now. I took it, I just got through eating the pan. I want to taste it.
Okay. But anyway. But yeah, so we're gonna have to wait a little bit. I don't know. Because it won't be outside the whole time, so I don't know if I'm gonna listen to music or listen to like Eisman's interview on the Allison Arnhem show. It's whatever. But I listened to Patrick Labrateau's interview on Ike Eisman's podcast, and it's all confusing. And it was really good. So I'm into the older shows now, like the 70s, 80s shows. So I'm really liking, which Ike Eisman, he's most like known for Race to Witch Mountain, and so yeah. I think his opposite was in Race to Witch Mountain, too. I mean, I think his opposite on Race to Witch Mountain was also in Little House. He was like in two episodes of Little House, and I think his opposite in Race to Witch Mountain was also in Little House. I think she was a sister to one of the, like, when Mr. Edmonds, if you don't watch Little House, you don't know, but Mr. Edwards had, like, three adopted kids, and I think this girl's sister, the one that was Miss Edwards' youngest adopted daughter, her real-life sister, I think was on his opposite of Race to Witch Mountain, if I'm correct. I can look it up. So, my mom's talking to my grandma on the phone if you hear anything. Race to Witch Mountain. Wait, it's not called Race to Witch Mountain? It's a 60s one. I'll have to look. I'll get back to you on that one. Yeah, her sister is Kyle Richards, who played in Little House, I'm pretty sure. So, his opposite on It's Return to Witch Mountain, not Race to Witch Mountain. 2009 Race to Witch Mountain with Anna Sophia Robb. I had no idea they made one in, like, the 70s. But they did, and Ike was in it. So, anyway, I never watched either of the movies, but I remember Anna Sophia Robb being in that movie. So, anyway. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it doesn't show playing IMDb today. Yep, Little House. Yep, she played a couple parts in Little House, 18 episodes. But anyway, so, anyway, bye for now, guys. I'm sorry, my brain is scatterbrained. But anyway, bye for now, guys. Also, she was in a movie, or her sister was in a movie with, my brain is bird squirrel. I'm sorry. ADHD, y'all. But she was also in a movie, and by the cover, I can just tell this is Ralph White by the poster, I can tell this is Ralph White, but it won't load. But anyway, I can tell by the poster it's Ralph White. Yep, Ralph White. And if you don't know who Ralph White is, he played... Oh, the series, not a movie, I'm sorry. He played on, I think my mom's talking about... I think they're talking about soap operas. But anyway, yeah, we're fictional people. We like fiction. But anyway, Ralph White, he played, John Walton on The Waltons, so John Walton Sr. You guys know I knew who Ralph White was. So. He's also been in a bunch of other things, but I'm sure the most of America... Well, he also played Gibbs' dad on NCIS. But most people, or at least I know him major... I always say majorly, and it's not a word. Majority of people will know him from Walton Land. That's pretty much what I know from. Even though I first saw him as Gibbs' dad, I more paid attention to him in the Waltons. Anyway, speaking of fiction, Justin Chambers, people talk like this confusing on podcasts and stuff, and I don't understand, so if you don't understand me, it's no big deal, because I don't even understand. Sometimes I can understand when people talk as fast as I'm talking right now, sometimes I can't, so if you can't understand me, I'm not upset at you whatsoever. So, anyway, what was I going to say next? I forgot, so, I forgot what I was gonna say, but anyway, so, yeah, but, oh, yeah, no, Grey's Anatomy, Justin Chambers, he's playing, I didn't know watch The Godfather, but he's playing on a Paramount show, like, they're doing a direct, like, the filming of The Godfather and casting, he's playing Marlon Brando, Justin Chambers, he will always be known as Alex to me. Like Alex, like through and through. No matter what he plays, he will always be Alex Crabb to me. So, anyway. So, bye for now, guys. Hey, guys. So, like I said, the cab won't be here till for a while. We got almost an hour. So, like 50 minutes. And so, we're just killing time. And all this stuff right here.
Yeah. I guess the first one
that
we could do the scope down your throat.
What, with that camera?
Yeah.
And the scope. But anyway, here's all this old medical equipment. Over here, this is kind of more interesting to me. Over here is... blood pressure. I didn't think I was filming for a second, but I am. Forceps.
Wow. That's like we look in the ear with over there, that scope. The medical bag.
I wonder if these were actually used at one point.
Yeah, it says blood pressure cuff used by Dr. Brody Nile. He was the one that founded the Nile Clinic that used to be behind here.
Now Kenan had like everything.
Yeah.
That's interesting, the book, but the forceps are what's the most interesting.
It is.
Now I see how there's a lot of injuries.
Dr. Luther, Kelly.
But you know, you can see how there's a lot of injuries when you're looking at that. Like how it could easily slip.
If you look at Colin Emily, he gets out the forceps. They take it in and go around. And you can see where stuff is slip, it hurts them.
I don't know why. First thing I thought of was Doc Baker when I looked at that.
Look at that.
Oh, my camera battery dying.
Look, there's snow. Look. That's cool.
My camera battery's dying. We came in here originally to get my mom something to drink. But the place where you get drinks is closed, so. Yeah. But anyway, back to my guys.